When a young artist is ready, sabi nga, one has to bring him into the limelight. Kaya naman, this time, hindi lang isa, kundi dalawa sa most promising artists ng Pilipinas na gumagawa na ng pangalan sa contemporary art ang ibibida namin sa inyo. Sweet and Shy, yan ang kadalasang first impression sa Manila-based artist na si Paula Hermar. Pero totoong looks can be deceiving dahil ang signature style at kadalasang subject sa bawat paintings ni Paula, hindi mo aakalain.
Maybe my signatures are like the skulls.
Yes.
It's like the smiling skulls. And it's like all happy skulls. Like I think like the other artists, well, sometimes it's kind of dark. But like I try to make the skulls like happy, like, cause like it's unusual for you to see like skulls, diba? So, so since it's not an everyday thing to see skulls wearing dresses and stuff, I try to make them like realize it's not that scary. Like they can do the everyday things, and like everyone has a skeleton anyway inside. You just don't see it.
She came from a family of doctors kaya mahilig na talaga sa anatomy si Paula. And aside from fine arts, pumasok rin siya sa fashion school kung saan mas lalo pang napiga ang creative juices niya as an artist. Dito sa Kaida Art Gallery, we were lucky at naipasilip pa ni Paula ang ilan sa mga sold out na niyang pieces. From her distinct color palette hanggang sa uncontrolled strokes at spontaneous creativity, masasabing vibrant masterpieces ang overall impact ng kanyang mga obra.
This piece is called Sushi Showdown because like we always go to Japan now. So recently we came from Japan and then like I love sushi. So I painted like what I remember. Cause like we ate so much sushi, so it's like sushi showdown. So there. So it's like usually I paint like what I do or like what I did, what I want to do. It becomes too bright for me, so I like put black. Cause like I don't want it super bright, and I don't want like sweet colors. Cause like my paintings are kind of girly-ish already, so I don't want to overkill it with like pastels and stuff. So it's gonna be too sweet, and I don't like that.
At dahil pa rin sa kanyang fascination sa skulls and skeletons, may kakaibang take sa dress-up doll si Paula. Ito ang almost three-dimensional at interactive niyang paper doll where you can actually dress up female skeletons.
This is my newest edition. It's my paper doll from my latest show in Kaida. So it's all wood. And then, like a paper doll, you can change their clothes. Do I change it?
Parang makikita mo yung background
ng fashion. Yeah, because like, I think if I paint the clothes and make it like this, it's quite easier than like making actual clothes. It's like, and it's fun.
So hindi na siya yung typical painting?
Yeah, it's more interactive now. It's still the same as my style, but like in a more interactive way. Like, if you don't feel like what she's wearing is nice, or like you change everything in your house, you can make it bagay.
Another artist who is making a mark on the current art scene, meet Joseph Texon, na ngayon ay isa na sa mga in-demand portrait painters ng bansa. All thanks to art.
Na-jail ako noong 2008. Yung brother ko na fine art student talaga, tinulungan niya ako through art. Pairam siya ng mga books sa akin. So inaaral ko siya. At the same time, sinabi sa akin mag-drawing ako. Kasi wala magawa sa jail eh. So parang paikot-ikot lang yung nangyari doon. So ginawa ko, nag-drawing ako. Nag-start ako mag-drawing using pencil lang tsaka paper. Tapos everyday, practice. And then nag-start ako mag-paint.
Alam niyo ba na ang kanyang unang project, portraits mismo ng mga dati niyang inmates? Noong una, wala nga raw siyang ideya na isa-isa na palang binibili ang kanyang mga likha. Later on, sumabak na rin sa kanyang first ever solo exhibit si Joseph, at mula noon, tuloy-tuloy na nga ang naging pag-arangkada niya sa art scene. Nito nga lamang ay naimbitahan pa siya sa Switzerland para ipinta ang ilang kilalang personalidad doon.
Ito yung book, coffee table book na binigay sa akin nung ano, nung White Space Black Box Gallery sa Switzerland.
So yun yung gallery?
Oo, ito yung pangalan ng gallery. Tapos ito yung title ng show. Mm-hmm. It means a solo show siya. So nag-residence ako, ito yung view ko doon.
For how long?
2.5 months. So nag-create ako ng 25 portraits from October to November. December 5 ako actually bumalik. Tapos, mga selected personalities yun eh. So, parang mga socialites ng mga tao.
Sa Switzerland.
He would normally prime his canvas with dark tones and pigments, and from here, mangingibabaw na ang bangis sa painting ni Joseph.
Close to abstract yung gawa ko pag malapit. Tapos, pag malayo makikita mo yung, yung realist ng mga.
Extremely unique at distinct vibe ng mga obra nila Paula Hermar at Joseph Texon, malakas talagang appeal sa modern eyes. Perfect example ng artist who took art to the next level. Mary Ann Bastasa, News Team 13.